Hey everybody, how's it going? Welcome back to the channel, and welcome, it says here in the sign, welcome to Sussex Farm. Now this is probably my favourite farm, well favourite map actually, and starting off on New Farmer, I think it is, the first one. So I'll show you around the farm. So here we've got the chickens, which I will be having. A couple of kitty cats on the roof. Bunny rabbits here, which haven't moved since I came on. Excuse me. And let's see the machinery. So we've got the case 7210. The trailer there, and we've got our seeder, the Baderstadt fertilizer. Plenty of storage space on this map, and that's why I like this map so much. What makes a map for me is the actual farm. The farm has got to be a good farm. Can be a rubbish scenery in the farm, it's good and I'll play it. But this one, the farm is really good and the scenery and that is good as well. Overall, a really good map. Then we've got the Massey Activa, if that's how you pronounce it, with the one header, so we need to get a corn header for that. And got a plough, cultivator, I think that is, and what I thought was another seeder, it's actually a weeder. Now I don't have the weeds on, so I will be selling that, give me an extra wee bit of money, and so yeah, plenty of storage space for everything you need, two big sheds. More storage around here. I won't be using some of these tools, so I'll be using the pallet fork. That's probably about it. And that, the bucket. Then we've got the Fent Favourite 515. We've got our grain bins here. Which these are probably my favourite great grain bins in all the maps. The multi-fruit ones. So that's where you get the stuff out, and this is where you put in. And you got the switch here to open hatch doors. I always leave them open because I always forget. And then around this way, we've got the pigs here. When you're in the slurry, you will be getting pigs. I love pigs. And we've got a cow barn here as well. The silage pit. I don't like these pits open at both ends. So I will be putting in a different one somewhere. There's plenty of space here to put something in. Like to be on this land. Yes, we do. So that's what we own. Fields 5 and 6. 5 is grass, 6 is... I could just look here. Wheat. Yeah, you could even put more sheds if you wanted to here. Or I'll be putting in a bunker silo somewhere. Probably in this corner here. And well, that's what I remember. You can turn off the... What's the word I'm looking for? You can turn off the hedges, if that's the word. So that you can drive through them. But we'll just leave them on just now. And we got, I can't remember what goes in here now. Could be liquid fertilizer. Can't remember. It's been a while. It's been a long time since I played this map. And then over here we got our seed dispensing and the fertilizer dispensing. You've got to put stuff in there first before you can get it out of there, obviously. And that's the farm. Favorite farm so far in the game. So I think field down here is ready. Yep, it looks ready. So to start with, what I'm going to do actually is sell the stuff that I'm not going to use, like the pickup. I'm not going to use that. I've got tractors. That plow can stay, cultivator can stay, cedar fertilizer, weeder. I don't have weeds on, so we shall get rid of that. I don't do bales. Pork, bale spike. Keep the weights. And the doormat. That's an extra 6,000. So we shall start by getting this field harvested. Maybe my reversing is horrible. Whoa! What's going on there? Let's turn around so that I can get out of that wee gap. Oh, the header's fallen. Am I going to be able to sort that? Probably not. Look on. It's going to put me around. There we go. Great start. Get back onto the trailer because I'm never gonna fit through a gap with this header on. Some of these trailers. The other way I've got to put it on. But let's get that trailer in a better spot to put it on. still not a good place. Yeah, I'm used to the case trailers because they stay on the headers no matter how rough your driving is. Sometimes my driving can be very rough. Into the field and doing the field. I do need to buy a forage wagon or pick it upper, as they call it. So find out how much that's going to cost me. Over here. So who's selling wheat. What's in there again? Who's got the best price? Sally Egg Bakery? No, Sealy P. Mr. Sealy P. Oh no, it's not. Jack and Jill. Windmill. Not too far actually. Remember how to get up to it. Today it's been a while since I've played on this map. Actually been a while since I've played Farming Sim altogether. Only just recently started playing it again. Up there so we can get across here. I have turned the traffic off. I hate the traffic. Because we're stupider than workers. Stupider is a word. Yeah, much we get for this. 12,125. Let me get up here. Okay. Come on. Come on. You can do it. Yes. Thousands. Not too bad at all. To the farm. These four crops will be one of the first bits of land that I buy. That'll do. Right, so get you in here as well. Right, so how much is the loading wagon? That's what it is, not forage wagon. 150,000. Well, that one's only 100,000. That one's only 46,000. 23,000 liters. Let's go for that one, because I need one to pick up that straw. Yeah, that will do. And go to the shop and get. There we are. Clean up some light. I've got to say, that's the sheep pen over there. Get all this picked up. Thought I was going to get it all in two loads, but didn't up. That's a field ready for cultivating, because it needs plowing. Needs plowing as well. Straw for pigs and cows, and I get money to buy some of those. So one of the jobs I do want to get done as soon as I can as well is go around here. Field 6, all this field here is all grass. So I'll be changing. First, I need to mow it. So, how much are the mowers? So, say 40, 50, 61 thousands. And how much are the windrowers? So, 84,000 in total, it's going to cost me. The machinery for that. So I'm gonna have to do some contracts in the meantime. But I think I shall end this video here. Just a short video. Okay, so we've got the rozzers somewhere. Wasn't me, didn't do anything. Yeah, so if you like this video, then please leave a like, subscribe if you're not already subscribed, and see you in the next one. If you want to give this map a go, then I would advise you do so. It's a very good map, and if I'm correct in thinking, the creator of this map is Alien Jim. I need to look that up, but I think that's who done this map. Very good map maker. Most of his maps that he's done that I've seen are very good, including this one. But I'm sure, correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm sure he did No Man's Land as well. So as I say, if you like this video, then please leave a like, subscribe, and we'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching. Take it easy.